Good morning.
Good morning, everybody.
I'm Elise. I'm a senior nutrition educator here at Community FoodBank of New Jersey, and I am with...
My name is Lindsey Kennedy, and I'm the director of child nutrition.
Welcome to Wellness Wednesday, right here live in our kitchen. We're going to be making two fun back-to-school recipes, quick little snacks that you can put together right when the kids come home from school. You know, try to hold them over to dinner time. They're definitely going to be hungry before running around, get them fueled up to do their homework, right?
Yeah.
So our first one is something special to Lindsey's family, so I'm excited to make these today.
So our first recipe is apple nachos, and so I'll just give you some background. Ever since I have two children, my son is 9 and my daughter is 6, and ever since my son was born, I would always be like, you know, when you're a new mom, you're grabbing stuff on the go. I always have like an apple on my hand as I'm like, you know, he's sitting on my lap playing, and he would always be going to like grab my apple and try to eat my apple. So he's a picky eater, but loves apples. Like, he seriously eats an apple a day, right? And, you know, keep the doctor away. So he eats an apple every day. So I try to take small wins, right? I know that, you know, I'm introducing other fruits and veggies during the day, but I know that I can get this into him, and it's a win all the time. So, and my other daughter loves apples as well. If I'm peeling them for my son, she's eating the skin. So it's a good recipe that I know is really great if they come home from school and they're hungry, which, right, like every child comes home and needs to like raid snacks because they're starving by the time they get home. So we make this after school, sometimes on weekends if they have soccer practice and they come home from the games, or even before games if you don't want to feed anything to them that's too heavy. This can be really, really good before or after sports too. So yeah, I use it a lot. It's great time because we're going into apple season.
Yes, it's just in like season.
I think probably in like a week, my son's favorite apple is a Honeycrisp apple.
Me too.
And they're always the first to come out, so we always have to go to the orchards like in August when it's like super hot and melting.
Not the time for your flannel, right?
Yeah, no, don't bring out the flannel yet. Put the Honeycrisp first. So we usually make this, but the great thing about it is there's so many different apple varieties that like my daughter really likes the like Granny Smith or like sour taste. So if you're making the recipe, you can use a few different varieties of apples, or you go with the same one. You can do half the plate on like one thing and half the plate on another. If you really specialize it, it's kind of like, I mean, I know it's like nachos, right? Or like a pizza. You can tailor it to however, you know, whoever you're serving it to really likes. So I'm going to take a plate and I'll start to organize it because we like to try to get a little bit fancy. So kids eat with their eyes first, right? So I try to make it look pretty and kind of do maybe a little decorative design, put it around the plate. The good thing too is if you're able, you can cut shapes into things. So my daughter right now is on a kick with me making hearts out of strawberries, which is very simple to do. But I've also got some tools on Amazon, so it's really simple. They're usually pretty cheap, but you can like cut flowers, hearts, leaves for the fall, and you can put like a few on top, kind of what you do to an apple pie. You can just put like a few designs on top if you want to make it really fun for them. And then we have some more apples here. So again, like I said, you could really do any kind of apple and a mix, and then that's kind of fun too because you might get sweet, sour. So we have the plate, and then the fun part, and this is a really great thing too, is you can get the kids like very involved in this. So after the parent maybe cuts the apple, well, prior to, right, you should always wash your produce, so we'll wash our apples and then the kids can help with that, and then I come in and I cut them up for the kids, and then they can just design their plates, or we can make one big platter if you have a big plate. So my daughter loves peanut butter, so usually we start with peanut butter. And another great thing about this is if you have a child that doesn't really like anything on their apples, you can serve them like this with just a few toppings and have a dip on the side. So we've done like different yogurt dips. I like to get plain yogurt and then tailor it with like a little cinnamon, so put some cinnamon in there, maybe a little honey for a sweetener, or sometimes I even just boil down blueberries with some cinnamon and lemon and make like a homemade blueberry sauce for it, which will be delicious on this as well. And you could do like a peanut butter and jelly kind of vibe. So for the peanut butter, a little hard, right? So I always microwave it for a few seconds, and that makes it like really easy to drizzle over, and more like a sauce to spread. So you just kind of drizzle it on, try to make it look pretty, just go back and forth. If you ever make those like chocolate covered strawberries, it's like you have to have the drizzle effect.
Yes.
Really good. The quicker you go, the better it comes out. But it doesn't have to be fancy. It's all going in the same place, right? So we put some peanut butter sauce on there. You can do granola. Again, if your kid has allergies, you can make homemade granola really easy if you have some oats and seeds, different things like that, honey. So I just sprinkle on some granola.
Now I'm looking for the seafood guidelines.
So really this recipe is just so versatile. You can make it to however you want.
Yep.
Like I got raisins or raisins. You can put
on top. Some raisins on top. My daughter loves cranberries. Mm. So I always put cranberries on here. You could do it, yeah. I mean, if you have a kid that really loves apples and you want to do like a fun play, if it's closer to a holiday or a birthday, you could even do like some colored sprinkles or some mini chocolate chips or something like that. What else do we have here? So, the cheese does that, right? So,
and some cinnamon.
Yeah,
cinnamon.
So, you could also do things like shredded coconut or
other fruit on top, maybe some raspberries.
Yeah, like raspberries or blueberries, especially if it's like around July 4th or Memorial Day, Labor Day. And we just sprinkle cinnamon on it. And then again, sometimes I serve it with a little dip on the side or some more peanut butter. And then it's really simple. Apple nachos. So that's all you
so
need.
Good.
Yep. And you can tailor it again, like however your kids like it. And it's filling. And they have some fiber in them.
Mm-hmm.
They're getting fruits and veggies.
Apples are so filling with the water content, the fiber content, whatever I have, just regular apple. I feel so full after, and that really carries me over until the next meal.
Yeah, it's a good, and then you have some more protein with the peanut butter, and depending on what toppings, you can really increase, you know, if you want some berries on there, you get more antioxidants, some vitamin C, and good stuff too. So you can really make it however you like it. And it's a good snack for adults too, because
sure.
We're always running and we need to keep up with the kids too. So it's something really easy and really quick you can make, even if you're home, between meetings, wherever. It's super easy. So we love this.
Yes.
We'll be eating it all fall long.
I'm gonna start making this now at home. Once you said apple nachos, like, we have to do those.
Yes. And the good thing too is if you find, I mean, we always have a ton of apples. Buy them every week, and then also if you go to the orchard, right, you have like tons of apples afterwards. Or even sometimes you buy fruit, and that, you know, even if like there's always the bananas that either I feel like in my house
bananas
they go
so good on this.
Yeah, they would go really well with the peanut butter.
Mm-hmm.
They go fast, or they sit there and turn brown. And I know over COVID, right, everybody was making banana bread, but with apples, if you have some apples that are starting to turn bad, you can really easily just again, put them on the stove and do some applesauce. And you only need a few ingredients for that. So that's like a really good, simple, easy kind of fall dish too.
Yeah.
Again, the kids can tailor that into adding, you know, like mango puree or blueberry sauce or whatever to increase the nutrients and then increase the flavor and everything too. So we always like to do that kind of stuff in the fall. We just, you know, our lives revolve around apple snacks in the fall.
It's a healthy alternative than baking apple pie, you know, with a lot of sugar. This is all natural sugar.
Yeah.
So it's definitely a healthier alternative. So maybe you bring it to Thanksgiving dinner table and
Yeah. I mean, it's a snack. My child is often, I'll say, getting the veggies in is a battle. So we're often eating apples with dinner just to have like a healthy component to, yeah, to dinner as well.
Awesome. Well, next we're going to do focus on some veggies. So we got our fruits and our veggies.
Yes.
I can't wait to try that after. When everyone's passing by, they're like, what are you making? I was like, apple nachos. They're like, what? So thank you so much for sharing your family recipe with us. That's great. And now hopefully you guys can try it at home. Try your family. You can drop it in the comments about what you want to try on to put on it. I would love to hear it because I'm definitely going to start making these, especially starting the apple picking soon, like Lindsey said. You get excited when you're going to the trees, right? So you always come home with a lot more things.
Yes.
So that's a great way to use them. Awesome. So we got our fruits, right? So now we're going to focus a little bit on our veggies. So this is another snack idea that you can put together pretty quickly, right when the kids come home from school. It's a mini avocado hummus quesadilla. So only a few simple ingredients, but of course you can add some other stuff if you want. So we're going to start with whole wheat tortilla, so we can get our whole grains in. I got like the regular big like fajita size tortillas, and using a simple cookie cutter to cut out the circles. I got about two per tortilla. To make them a little smaller, a little bite size, so they're more of a snack.
I love that they're small because I feel like kids gravitate. Oh, it's so cute. It's small. It's not as like overwhelming as a big tortilla, and they're more likely to try it and eat it.
Exactly. Right, it's more bite size. It's cute. So we got a couple of these on here. Then we have some hummus, which around the stores have so many flavors of hummus. I saw everything but the bagel seasoning, spicy hummus if you're into that. I got roasted red pepper, so we got that red pepper, we got some veggies in. Or you can get garlic, plain, wherever you like. You also make your own hummus. I've done it before with some kids. Just add chickpeas in the blender. You don't need like a fancy food processor. I did it all in the blender. 1, 2, 3. It really came together nice, and then you get to keep it, in your fridge for the rest of the week. I also have some avocados here, which I was going to the store, and I'm like feeling all the avocados to see which ones are just right for today. So I got lucky. I got some green ones.
It's always hard to find an avocado. Have you ever tried freezing them? I know.
No.
You say I've bought frozen ones before, and frozen too. So if you do have them, that they're at that good stage and you can't use them for anything right at that moment, you can always freeze them and then you pull them out and then you can use them.
That's awesome. If you have the right, it's a little squishy, so I feel like either today or maybe we can freeze them.
Yeah.
I also heard putting lemon juice on it can help save it and then wrap it in saran wrap. Yes, but unfortunately, that is a short lifespan.
Yeah.
So definitely, that prefer just to eat it while it's open. So I have some avocado, and then I shredded some Monterey Jack cheese. Do you buy shredded cheese, or do you grate it yourself?
A combination of both,
depending on
what I see. Yeah.
Well,
now that I'm thinking about it, I know I went to like look at that bowl before, but you could do a savory version of this as well, and you could probably sprinkle some shredded cheese on the apples and some other stuff.
I have not, but
that's like, my kids also love cheese, so we might have to do a test this fall.
Yeah, this one I did the Monterey Jack cheese, but you can pick whatever one you like. I got the block cheese. I was feeling fancy this morning. I wanted to shred it myself. I think it falls nice and melts nice, so. So we'll get started. So we're gonna take our little tortilla. I'm gonna start with my hummus. So like I said, I got roasted red pepper hummus. Just gonna spread it on there. It's kinda like, I guess it'll start to look like a pizza, right?
Yeah, that's my favorite flavor too.
And then we can put some avocado on it. Do your kids like avocado?
They're not big on the avocado. They used to eat it when they were babies, and now they've grown up and have the interests, but I have more of like a celery carrot lover on the one side, and then just a challenging picky eater on the other side. We just try new things all the time. But what I have found is that if I make smoothies, I can sneak in a lot of things.
Ooh,
if they're not as adventurous and not willing to try something like this, you can always do a smoothie. We freeze them into ice pop molds and have like breakfast smoothies in the morning. I think they're eating ice pops and, you know, do
it's all about
that.
So maybe with these, you can check them as well, because we're going to melt the cheese with the hummus, maybe.
Yeah, that's, you know? I mean, they love cheese, they love quesadillas, so this is a great
way. Well, you just call it a quesadilla,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's a great way to,
and it wasn't, make it, if you want to add a little bit more spice, you know, add a chili pepper or cumin, or I love to add most of that pepper to, like, everything.
Yeah.
Or even some garlic, you know, so you can always make it how you like, or even some of that everything but the bagel seasoning. I love that.
Yeah.
Then we're gonna fold them in half and throw them on, well, throw them, gently place them on our pan. So we, it's all heated up here, so we're gonna fold them in half. So make it just like that. And we're gonna cook it on each side, just about 2 to 3 minutes, just to get that cheese a little melty, avocado a little creamier. So sometimes I'm picky about my avocado too. Like, it's, I love guacamole, but like just avocado. But I'm thinking with, this with the other flavors inside, that it's really good. It's gonna taste really good. So we have our spatula over here. I'm just gonna put in our pan. Do about 2 to 3 minutes each side. Let the cheese start melting. It already smells pretty good.
Yeah, and I love the idea of adding like some seasoning to make it kind of taste like a taco. Like, I know my son likes tacos, so maybe if I put some of that seasoning in with the hummus, you know, it would like
taco season.
More reminiscent of tacos. You might actually try it.
Yeah.
So I love that. And like, this is something I would eat, definitely.
It's also good for us, right?
Yeah.
So therefore, you make a big plate, that they take some, you take some, and it came together, two minutes, right, to put that together.
And I know that, you know, my kids will eat stuff cold a lot of times. So if you have, if you're making this after school, but then have some leftovers, this would probably be great for lunch boxes.
Yes.
The next day, I will admit I hate making lunches for my children every day.
And that's
why I put it off at night. But the great thing is they're at an age where they can get involved. So if they're trying like these types of snacks after school, it's good. You know, you could tell them, they could pull them out, they can add them to their lunch. They have fruits and veggies in there. It's really easy. Put them in a cute container and pack it up for lunch.
Right. And this is just a snack with the whole grains. You're getting your fiber, hummus, you're getting your protein because all those chickpeas, avocado, you're getting those healthy fats. So it's a really nice, healthy little after school snack. Do you kids help you cook in the kitchen?
Yes, we do.
Fun.
I'm in there.
Uh-huh.
The dog will be underneath us, and the kids bring over their stools. Well, for my daughter, my son's almost as tall as me, but they'll bring their stools over, and they want, like, you know, weekends if we're making pancakes, and I'll give them the easy things. Like, they love to mix, but you throw in blueberries, wash the blueberries for me, or give them, like, butter knife or a dull knife, and they can slice up some stuff that's easy, like bananas and stuff like that too. Yeah, so they love to help me out.
Yeah, it's fun to have them in the kitchen, right?
Yep. It goes slower, but it's really good to get them involved because then they're more likely to taste it.
Exactly. Right.
Especially if they can add in their little flair of things that they like and tailor it to, you know, add a seasoning or a spice that they might like better.
So, you know, trying out whatever they want to try out. Maybe we can learn even a thing from the two of them, right?
Yeah, I've started to get them involved. You guys help me pick out your snack, pick out a fruit, or pick out a veggie. You know, make sure what you want for lunch, make sure it's something that's healthy. The good thing is, too, sometimes the schools will reinforce the messages, so it's always great when the teacher says, you have to bring a healthy snack in for snack time, because then they'll come home and they want to pick out a healthy snack, so.
Yeah, that's right. What they learn in school, they're there for so long.
Yeah.
These are going to be snacks that other kids at the lunch table are going to be jealous of.
Yeah.
They're going to be trading these.
Right.
Snacks, right. So the cheese got nice and melty. it's a little warm, which I think FoodBank, like you said, it'll also be really good cold too, like the next day snack. So easy, you could just put a few of them together and then throw them in the lunchbox the next day. Or even like a weekend snack.
Yeah.
You're sizzling.
Yeah. And I think even if like, if you have a child that doesn't really like hummus, this would still be good without it, right? You have avocado, you have cheese, and maybe think of something else to throw in there that they might like. But yeah, this is like the nachos. It can be really versatile.
Yeah. And you can put like black beans in here.
Yeah, that would be great.
Right, the black beans would be good. And if you have some leftover veggies from the weekend, cut up some extras, maybe zucchini the night before, you have some extra zucchini, you know, never throw out extra food, right? You gotta save it. So you can always throw like the leftover veggies in here, peppers, onions.
Yeah. Even a serve with like again, my kids are dippers, so like any kind of dip, like a salsa or anything, you know, that they might like. My nephews love salsa, so if they could dip that, they might.
Too. Yeah, so these are really good after school snacks. I'm also thinking weekend snacks, you know, especially with the fall coming up. Maybe some football Sundays. I'm going to make some MID snacks instead, right?
Right.
Definitely a healthier alternative. So I don't know about you, but I definitely want to try one of these once these finish up.
Yeah, they look good. They do smell good too.
Wellness Wednesdays, and hope you have a great rest of your time.
Thanks, everybody.